use an open cell foam. Remember, the open cell foam per pound is cheaper than closed cell foam. It's cheaper are the two types of insulation, but it's a better sound barrier. So you're going to have an incredible sound barrier, and it works really good. If somebody is totally screaming in the other room, and you put this in your walls, it's going to be like a muffle. It has an STC rating of 42. If you knew anything about sound coefficiency, that's extremely high. So you have an incredible sound barrier. It keeps dust and pollen out of the house, so your air quality is healthier. So if you're an elderly person with emphysema or breathing issues, this is going to help out a lot. Allergies, anything like that has to do with breathing, you're going to be breathing clean air, so it's healthier. It'll also slow down insects. Little bugs and stuff can't make it through it. They can't get through the walls. Your comfort level goes way up because of the R value and the air sealing. It's completely air sealed. So your comfort level is going to go way up, and of course your utility bills are going to go way down. Now, with injection foam, a couple things need to happen. The inside of the wall has to be completely empty. It can't have just some insulation or just a little bit. It's got to be completely empty. No, there's nothing you can do. You could cut a 4-inch hole at the bottom and pull the insulation out at the bottom. It doesn't work. We've tried it once. By the time we were done with that wall, we would have been better off just pulling the drywall off and spraying the thing. So, no, it has to be empty. The homeowner has to be sure of it, or I come out there, I drill a hole, and I have a scope that you stick inside. A 1/2-inch hole has to be drilled, and I put a scope in there. Also with injection foam, it will only work on vertical walls or vaulted ceilings. Vaulted ceilings means it's got a slope to it. Let's say I inject the foam into a flat ceiling. What would happen, the injection foam is really slow activating. We turn the heaters down on the equipment to where it doesn't react very fast. The material comes out as a liquid. It would just puddle right where we would inject it in the ceiling. It has nowhere to roll. We inject it on a wall, the material rolls down the wall slowly, and all of a sudden it starts activating and expanding. Same thing with a vaulted ceiling. It rolls down the ceiling, gravity takes it, and it activates, and then it just fills up the entire cell. If we just have a flat ceiling, the material has nowhere to go. It doesn't roll anywhere. And then what would happen, it would activate just right there, and you'd have this big blob of material right at the area that you injected it in. It would not fill up the cells. You would probably end up blowing out the drywall if you tried to do it. There's a lot of pressure in this material. It has to go somewhere. It has to be on a vaulted ceiling or a vertical wall. Blown-in insulation. It's blown in with a big 4-foot wide hose. It's crap that they blow in the attics. And it's like dirt. It looks like you're piling up dirt in your attic. A buck a square foot difference between an insulation that you'll have to redo in probably 10 years and that will really not save you any money. It might muffle the sound a little bit, but as far as saving dollars on your utilities, you might save a few bucks. It's better than nothing. Let's put it that way. That's what cellulose does for you. All it is chopped up newspaper. That's it. That's all it is recycled newspaper and books, and they just grind it up, and you have cellulose. My material here, I have never had anybody complain about not seeing 40% decrease in their utility bill. Heat on the exterior of the house, it enters the wall, and the insulation loads up to 100%. Once it's 100% heat load, it now allows the hot air to enter into the home. So say you have R13 in the walls opposed to R30 in the walls. It's going to take a lot longer for heat to penetrate that wall in a R30 than it is in a R13. So it's not if it's going to penetrate the wall. It's a matter of when. It just prolongs the time. With an air seal, it stops it completely. Now, the manufacturer had to put an R value on this material because that's what the cities have to gauge their inspections by. They don't understand, or they aren't totally on board with the full air seal with spray foam. They did have to put an R value. So there's an R value of 3.7 per inch with open cell foam. So the inspector comes out and says, okay, well, what are you doing here? Oh, we're putting spray foam in there. Well, what's the R value? Oh, the R value doesn't matter because it's a total air seal. That sends the inspector in a total mental meltdown. They don't know what to do, don't know what to say, so they come up with a gauge on the foam, on what the R value, what they think should be per inch to satisfy the cities. The only thing that's different as far as what we do with the chemical is we don't heat it as much. When we spray open cell foam, typically it's around 135 degrees. This, we keep it around 90 degrees because the hotter it is, the faster it reacts. So we put it at 90 degrees so it allows time for the material to roll down the wall or roll down the vaulted ceiling to get to the bottom to where it reacts slowly so that you know that the whole cell is getting filled. There are rebates through Energy Upgrade California. You have to hire a energy inspector prior to doing our job. He'll test the home with a lower door test, and it can test the air sealing of the house. And he does a full evaluation, and he recommends scopes of work like what we're doing. And then we do our thing, and then he retests the home. After we're done doing our job, he retests it again. And then he sends that information into the city, and they qualify for rebates. That's the BPI inspector's trade.